Hello everyone, I am Dr. Mohammad Sirajul Faizi, Assistant Professor, Department of Chemistry, Langat Singh College, Muzaffarpur. Today in this video, I am going to explain about application of malonic ester. So welcome you all in my YouTube channel. Hope this video will be helpful to you. So let us start with malonic ester. You can see here, this is the structure of malonic ester. Here is CH2 group, which is known as active methylene group. Why it is active? Because these two group is electron withdrawing groups, which is attached with the CH2 group, and these hydrogens become acidic. We know that this is alpha hydrogen, so it become acidic and stabilized by resonance. So what is application of malonic ester? So first applications, you can see here, this is anion of malonic acid. When it react with the base, anion will form, and this cyclobromo compound will attack on this center, forming this like a structure. And on subsequent reaction with hydrolysis and decarboxylation, forming these products. So COOH and CH2, this part is coming from malonic ester, and this part which is cyclized form coming from alkyl bromide. Now second example, this is CH2, you know, malonic ester. Base attack on this center and abstract H+, forming carbanion. Subsequent alkyl halide will attack on this center, mono substituted products. On hydrolysis, ester become acid. On decarboxylations, this 4-methoxy pentanoic acid will form. Next example, you can see here, malonic acid remove alpha hydrogen, forming carbanion. This alkyl halide attack on this center, this positive charge, forming these mono substitutions. On decarboxyl, on hydrolysis, forming COOH. On decarboxylation, give this product. So you can do in a step by step or single step. You can write is sodium ethoxide, alkyl halide, and hydrolysis and decarboxylation. You see step by step, sodium ethoxide take this proton, forming carbanion. This carbanion attack on this carbon, and this Cl bond, carbon Cl bond will break. NaCl remove, 1,3-dichloropropane. Now this again, there is a one hydrogens. This hydrogen again remove with the help of base, forming carbanion, and this carbanion further attack on CH2, remove this Cl-. So cyclizations occurs, minus NaCl cyclization occurs. This COOEthyl group converted into COOH. On hydrolysis and further heating, carbon dioxide will remove, and cyclobutane carboxylic acid will form. Another examples, you see malonic acid, all reagent in subsequent manner. Base in THF, this is alkyl halide, and this is hydrolysis and decarboxylation. You will get these products. So this part is from malonic, and this part will come from alkyl halide. You see the structure, a match with this structure. You see the mechanism further, ethoxide will take this proton, carbon ion will form, alkyl halide attack on this carbon, forming mono substitutions. On hydrolysis, COOH will form. On decarboxylation, acid will form, and further if you react with ethanol, again ester will form. Then this is again malonic acid react with base, and subsequent one compound which contains two bromine. So these three carbon. So this carbon will attack on this center, and again one hydrogen is there, carbon ion will form, and further reactions on this center forming this cyclized border. Again, you know the CH2, same thing you can do with the four carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4 carbon, then you will get this product. This again, one negative charge is here, this positive charge will attack here, you will get the 5 member ring, and on hydrolysis and heating you will get this product. Further, this is diethyl malonate, concentrate on the center, again base will tap and forming carbon ion, and 1,4-dibromobutane, you will get the cyclized products. You will get this is cyclized product. Further, you see there are malonic acid, malonic ester, this is the base, and this is alkyl halide, you will get these products. Again, malonic acid react with this. Further, this is monosubstituted, this is disubstituted acid. So COOH will coming from malonic acid, and this part is coming to alkyl halide. One is here, one is here. Now again, you see malonic ester react with 1,2,3-dibromopropane. In presence of base, subsequent heating, you will get this one. And this KOH reaction, hydrolysis occurs, and decarboxylation, you will get this product. Now you have malonic ester react with diazo compounds, will introduce on this center into and react with the acetic anhydride, right, and diethylamine, subsequent acidification, you will get these products. And this product further, you see here, this part is malonic acid and this part is just coming from the reactions. On hydrolysis and decarboxylation, we will get this product. This is alpha amino acid, very good application. Again further, this is the malonic acid, sodium ethoxide forming the carbon ion, alkyl halide, monosubstituted, subsequent hydrolysis, you will get the acid. On heating, decarboxylation, you will get this product. Again, one proton is there, so alkyl halide react, disubstituted products. On hydrolysis, you will get dicarboxylic acid. On decarboxylation, you will get the disubstituted monocarboxylic acid. Now you see the malonic acid react with urea, forming barbituric acid. This is very important compound, barbituric acid. Now Gabriel malonic ester synthesis, you see this is malonic acid react with N-sulfanilamide, react with the base and RX. Again this R group attached here because this is the part of malonic. And on hydrolysis this ester become acid, and on heating decarboxylation occurs and alpha amino acid will form. Now you can see here, this is the leaving group and this is the group which is there. So in one step all the time you will get the base, then alkyl halide, again base, again alkyl halide. On hydrolysis, on decarboxylation, you will get this product. So this is the one more examples. This is malonic acid and this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbon containing dibromide. React, it will form the 6 member ring. On decarboxylations and hydrolysis, you will get this product. So this is further examples. If you have the malonic ester, you have this type of alkyl halide, you will get this type of products. And again on subsequent hydrolysis, you will get the acid, and on hydrolysis and on heating decarboxylation will occur, you will get hexonic acid. Now you see, I just take the photo of these questions and try to understand, and what is the product P, Q, R, S, just write it down. This is the questions starting from this malonic acid, how you will get this product. Answer is this, if you have malonic acid, if you have such type of alkyl bromide, you will get this product. On hydrolysis, you will get this product, and on hydrolysis as subsequent decarboxylation, you will get this product. Now we have another question. If you have malonic acid, what will form? Just take the photo and try to give the answer. This is another question. If you have malonic acid, what you will be products if you react with this alkyl bromide and subsequent hydrolysis and decarboxylations? So this is another question. If you have the malonic ester react with this alkyl halide, you will get this product. If you react all this, what will get, what is the structure of B? Just concentrate on that. Now if you have malonic acid, you react with the base alkyl halide, again you do the base, you have another alkyl halide, hydrolysis, heating, what you will get, just write it down, the structure. Hope this video will be helpful to you. If you like this video, then subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching.